rocket engine ignition. High pressure and hot gases test materials to their very limits.
When you look at such a rocket engine, you have a rocket wall, fluid flow, high Mach numbers, of course, high Reynolds numbers, extreme heat. You can find surprisingly similar processes right here in the human lung. Air flows at very high speeds through the bronchial tubes and past the razor-thin walls of the lungs. Here we describe phenomena that function according to physical, biological and chemical principles using mathematical equations. Scientists in the chair for numerical mechanics at the Technische Universität München have been studying how the lungs work. The result? A numerical model that can calculate the extremely complex conditions in the lung. The model visualizes the way air flows through the lungs. The flowing stream of air deforms the tissue, which in turn alters the flow of air. Calculating these complex interactions is very computationally intensive. The goal is to make real predictions for certain illnesses, specific scenarios and given patients. With our model of the lung, we are the first researchers worldwide being able to do these kinds of calculations. The model is particularly relevant for artificial respiration. When patients with pulmonary disease receive artificial respiration for days, their survival rate drops below 50%. We simply don't know how air is really distributed during breathing and how this complex but vital process actually works. What the researchers do know: the tissue in the lung looks quite like a sponge, and this sponge is in constant motion. When we inhale air, the lung tissue expands. When we exhale, it contracts. What doctors would like to know is the level of stress that will put a patient at risk. And this is precisely what we looked at in the computer. We determined, for example, that an overall expansion of 10% can cause up to 40% expansion locally. There are hotspots in the geometry in which up to fourfold expansion takes place. In collaboration with colleagues from the departments of biology and medicine, the researchers are now working on transferring their results into practice. That could save thousands of patient lives in the future.